What's up? This is Yazz, a student coming at you with another What's Hot on the Screen. I hope you are good. This week brings a lot of diverse content, especially with film releases. So I think there may be a little something in here for everyone, from comedies and teen dramas all the way to action films and docuseries. And we're going to be starting with the films. Now, there are quite a few movies coming onto online platforms, and this morning Netflix released what is very much an Oscar bait film with The Trial of the Chicago 7. Chicago 7 is an Aaron Sorkin biopic starring the likes of Eddie Redmayne and Sacha Baron Cohen, and it is centered around a group of seven defendants who are charged by the federal government with conspiracy in the 60s for inciting to riot, as well as other charges related to the anti-Vietnam War and countercultural protests that took place within Chicago, Illinois within the late 60s, around 67.
At the defense table,
Abby Hoffman, Jerry Rubin, Dave Dellinger, Rennie Davis, Lee Weiner, John Froines, Tom Hayden, and Bobby Seale.
These defendants had a plan, and the plan was to incite a riot.
I call this portion of the trial with friends like these.
It's an entertaining biopic, but you also know you're going to be getting very much a lot of witty dialogue and Sorkinisms. For those looking for a little bit more action comedy, Showmax has recently acquired Shaft. This 2019 adaptation finds Samuel L. Jackson leading the reins on this iconic blaxploitation property. In this version, Jackson teams up with his son, John Safter Jr., to figure out the murder of Jr.'s best friend. And then for those looking for a little bit more romance and comedy, Netflix recently released a Kenyan rom-com called Disconnect. This film is very much an ensemble piece that unpacks and explores situationship culture and the struggles that come with it. It's witty, it's funny and relatable for those looking for something just a little bit more cozy. And yeah, those are some of the films that are coming out this week.
We've got a bachelor party to kick off.
Okay.
What's Khalid's last name?
Shots, anyone?
Khalid's last. Your last name is Let's Get This Party Started. I haven't been out in ages, man. It's Muhammad, right? Ali.
Nope.
Abdallah.
Moving on to series, Netflix has recently released another teen drama. This time, this one is set within Brooklyn, New York, and it's called Grand Army. Grand Army places us in the largest public school within the city and brings us into the world of the student within the school. It's got a very gritty and melodramatic feel to it, and it's going to be one of those series that looks to like tackle hot button issues. I mean, in its first episode alone, there's a suicide bombing that happens at a park near the school that sends the school into a lockdown. And then we're introduced to the world through the students within a suicide lockdown situation. It's a very diverse cast, so it's a bit of like tackling racism and a lot of things. So if you like teen dramas, melodrama, this is something for you.
I got plenty of stuff I need protection from. And not one of them is what will happen if I step out that door right now.
That's the school to prison pipeline.
They're my friends.
And then finally, my last pick, which is my personal recommendation, is Journey of an African Colony. So this is a docuseries on Netflix that I started watching yesterday. The show is produced and narrated by Olasopu Sasore. Some of the research used is found from his books, as well as research that's been hidden within libraries within Britain, from various diaries to like different types of anecdotes. So essentially, Journey of an African Colony traces Nigeria's history of slave trade and colonial occupation to its independence. So if you want to learn some compelling African history, this is definitely something to go to. And yeah, this has been What's Hot on the Screen.